best, be, best behavior topics. Or not. Did you know that there's a KFC or KFCs in which part of the world yesterday? Is it, was it London? Was it England? Was shutting down because of a shortage of chicken?
Really?
Yes. My God, I can't even. It makes. I start hyperventilating just thinking about it. Lord, please let that not be Jamaica. All right. So let's go to the real hot topics.
Go to the real hot topics. I don't know how to process this one. So it was on the news, actually. I think it was our lead story in prime time. Students send school shooting voice note. Oh, I didn't even know shooting was in it. Neither. I know there was a threat. I didn't know they were shooting. Questioned by police. The police today questioned a high school student who sent a voice message, a high school here, sent a voice message to a teacher threatening to carry out a shooting at the institution. In his ramble, the boy complained of being ostracized and abandoned by persons close to him in his time of need. Mm-hmm. The 17-year-old was questioned along with parents. A relative who was interviewed reportedly stated, and I'm saying reportedly, because many of this child never get no attention with this relative I come from, no one know everything about the child. So the teen was found reading a book. I'm not going to say that. This sounds a little contrived, but okay. Which they later destroyed.
It's supposed to be a book that has an association, they say. A number with the association of the devil. But they reportedly, says the relative, they destroyed the book.
Yeah.
But the ministry is assisting police, they say, in conducting a psychological assessment of the student. It was a scary thing for...
It must have been coming on the heels of what happened in Florida. It must have been.
But I've spoken to people, well, I've seen people tweeting who I respect their opinions and so on. And they say this boy sounds like a boy who needs attention, who needs love, who needs
clearly
lonely. And
but he's saying that. That's exactly what he's saying. And he's saying, you know, he calls, people don't answer, whatever, you know.
Yeah, but it's a bigger issue.
It's a bigger issue. Yeah. It's a bigger issue. Because when you have a child in a place where there are so many and yet they feel alone.
High school is hard, you know.
That says something.
High school is hard because kids will let you know how they feel about you. Mm. Whether it's ostracizing you and not talking to you at all, or just being plain mean and just wicked.
Yeah.
I mean, mean spirited. I don't even know if they know what they're doing, but it's if you don't have a strong sense of self, you will get lost in it.
Don't even think they know what they're doing. I remember kids are coming with different frames of reference at home. So if they're used to a certain type of behavior, which seems okay to them, but at home, you know?
That's a tough place.
But we have to find a way, Simone, because I'm sure it's not just this one young man. It's not just this one young man.
The whole problem to identify who the people are having problems and try and reach them.
And it's not just secondary school.
Mm-hmm.
So my thing is, what are the things, because when you talk nowadays, it's always about work and the kids are in extra lessons. There's one school I was complaining, I won't say which, that clearly this child is going to a full-time work.
It's a job.
To get up from so early in the morning and be at school until so
especially
late. So we have to look at also what are the systems that we have in place for our to socialize our children. What are the systems that we have to socialize our children, to help them understand the process of socializing, and those who feel as if they're not a part of something, how do we create an environment that is inclusive for them? So, you know, let's drop them off at the gate and them go do the schoolwork, and then them still do the work, and then they reach home and I work again, and you just push the electronics to them, and then, you know,
This is home and school.
This is another wake-up call. Because remember the little boy, I don't know if it was ever proven.
The one who took his life.
So.
And this young man, they say, reportedly tried to do that twice. So this is a young man who was in a lot of trouble.
And you know, I don't think we provide this kind of support enough for our men. Because they're young men and young boys with 10%. Talk up yourself. We are cry. We say, but you look at
weak.
It.
Weak.
Yeah, you're too weak. And we don't provide support for our men. And Girl Power Tuesday, me, I tell you so. We don't provide support for our men. And we should.
All right. August Town, my word. The year before last award for No Murders for the Year.
Yeah.
Or was it last year? Was it year before last or last year? Recently,
big, 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 big smile, Jamaica community,
you know. Huge thing.
Every man in August Town, the men in August Town, tune in to this program. Warm to know.
Yep.
Warm to know, August
Town. So the violence has once again started to flare up. Now the residents are saying Indicom is a problem. This says residents in the Jungle 12 community of August Town were restive after a team from Indicom visited the area to investigate an early morning gun attack that left a correctional officer at the Tower Street Adult Correctional Center dead.
Yeah.
Oh boy.
35-year-old person.
He was shot dead by gunmen who were in the area firing high-powered weapons. After that shooting subsided, two policemen who were trying to preserve the crime scene were also allegedly attacked, resulting in a shootout. One of the policemen was injured in the incident, and the two were forced to retreat, and the gunmen escaped. So the councillor stepped in, Benicia Phillips, said what residents witnessed was an assault on the police and on the community. She said that, understand why we have no difficulty with Indicom. We want to make sure that citizens feel safe. And anything that looks like the police will be placed in a situation where they're going to pull back for whatever reason, then the citizens are not going to have it. Mm-hmm. So
I think Indicom and the police commissioner need a come to Jesus moment. Need a nice sit down. I mean, not a this is going to be a news bite moment. Not a this is a camera moment. This is a Jamaica is suffering under crime moment, and we have to find a way now to make it work. In the common, know you have your work to do. JCF have the work to do too, a lot of it. We have to find a way. Because
and
it's
find
not pretty.
Some common ground. Yeah. Because the constant is only helping to embolden
to Jesus moment.
The criminals. Right.
Finally, we have to go. PNP taking NIDS fight to court. Opposition leader Peter Phillips has signaled that he will be taking the law to the Constitutional Court for it to be struck down. They are accusing Prime Minister Holness of being stubborn. Phillips says he will not allow the sections of the law that encroached on the constitutional rights of the people to go unchallenged. So we will see where that takes us. Yep.
All right.
Yeah.
You have any birthdays, lady? 20th of February.
We don't find them yet. So I'm just going to say happy birthday to everybody.
Well, when you come back.
And when I'm member, I will say.
Okay. So Shauna, we made it back in time. 6:17. Happy birthday to everybody celebrating on the 20th of February. Have a fantastic day today.
Of those who lived and died for the oneness of all people, so let us all begin.